man.
This way, please, gentlemen. Monsieur, it is my great ambition to demonstrate that nature is a closed system, that in any transformation, no amount of matter, no mass, is ever lost and none is gained. Over here, please. This precise amount of water is heated to steam. This steam is brought into contact with a red-hot iron barrel embedded in the coals. From this end, we cool the steam. But interestingly, we collect less water than we started with. So clearly, we lose a certain amount of water. However, we also collect a gas, and the weight of the iron barrel increases. Now, when we combine these two increases, the new weight of the iron barrel and the gas we have collected, they are exactly equal to the weight of the lost water.
Ah, but is it atmospheric air, Monsieur Lavoisier?
No. No, because I am measuring it to the very last grain. I can see that it is lighter than the air around us. And moreover, it is flammable. Voila.
Water is made out of hydrogen and oxygen. So what he had done is get the oxygen to stick to the inside of a red-hot iron rifle barrel. He was basically just making rust, which is oxygen and iron, but he was making the rust really quickly. Now that left the hydrogen, what he called combustible air, and that was just floating around as a gas. No mass had been lost, it had merely been transformed. And now, he wanted to transform it all back into water.
This is only the beginning. In the next few months, I hope to demonstrate that I can recombine this combustible air with vital air and transform them both back into water. I will recreate exactly the same amount of water that was lost here in this process. It is my hope to complete the cycle, water into gas, into water, and not a drop lost.
For a long time, Lavoisier had suspected that the exact amount of matter, the mass, involved in any transformation was always conserved. But to prove this, he had to perform thousands of experiments, and he had to do the measurements with incredible accuracy. That's where his great wealth from being a tax collector came in. He could afford to commission the most sensitive instruments ever built. He became obsessed with accuracy.
Expose this persecutor of yours.
For years, the Lavoisiers burned, chopped, melted, and boiled every conceivable substance. They'd shown that as long as one is scrupulous about collecting all the vapors, liquids, and powders created in a transformation, then mass is not decreased. Liquids might become gases, metals may rust, wood may become ash and smoke, but matter, the tiny atoms that make up all substances, none of it is ever lost. The crowning glory of this opus was their remarkable use of static electricity to cause oxygen and hydrogen to recombine back into water.